Hello, you. Welcome back to Geekism. We join ourselves. You join me in Planet Coaster. We're cracking on with King Coaster. And the last one we built, Woody Coaster here. And it's going to be named by one of you guys, the most liked comments. And a really good name, actually, was by Gilad Teller, who said, call it the Gold Rush, as it represents the purpose of this coaster, which is very good. So we are going to name it the Gold Rush. We're not going to give it a Western theme, though, because, you would think with the name like the Gold Rush, it would be a Western theme. But we've done the Western theme quite a bit on the channel already. So we're going to give it a different theme. But we are going to decorate it, because I'd like to pop this onto the workshop, because I think it might be useful for some people. And also, it's not an awful coaster. One thing I did do off camera was... Oops, we'll zoom in really far. One thing I did do off camera was add a block break section here. It doesn't change the stats particularly much, although it does... Just slow it down every slightly. It still fills the criteria for this first hard gold star there. So, and it gets two cars running. So it's very profitable. You'll see one's going around here. The other one is getting filled up. As this one goes out, this one comes up. They run really smoothly. There's no stalling at any point in the ride. Really nicely timed, if I do say so myself. So, I'm quite happy with it. So I'm going to pop it onto the workshop. But for that, we need a bit of a station. So... I know we're only going for a couple of minutes. We're going to dive straight into a time lapse. We're going to get a station built here. I've got a feeling I'd like to try a bit of a Nordic-y feel. Nothing too heavily themed. It's going to be relatively generic coaster, so that if people do want to use it themselves, they can drop it in. But I did like the idea of going a little bit Nordic with it. So that's what we're going to do. Let's see how we get on. I've cut it there. I didn't realise when I first started that we haven't got a lot of scenery unlocked here. So I haven't really been able to do is fully decorate the lights. I've left the back. What I might do is save this as a blueprint, take it over into a sandbox park and do a lot of more stuff with it. Because I do want to start putting some more stuff on the workshop. So I think I'll do that. But for now, it's a start. It's got a bit of a Nordic feel. A nice bit of detailing around the roof there. But I haven't really actually got the roof pieces that I wanted to use unlocked, so I've been a little bit limited in what I've been able to do, but at least it looks pretty smart. And now the queue scenery is probably 100, 88, because actually a lot of the queue is here. We're going to be able to increase the price. One thing I did want to do when I originally did this queue was to build a little bit of a sort of open bit. Now, whether or not we have the pieces we want, framework, this piece was the one I was hoping to have. I want to just kind of turn that around, and as best I can, make like a grid over the top of the queue. Actually, it's stuff we've messed a little bit with it before, but I just had an idea that I wanted to do it again. So, just going to do this to see if it gets in anybody's way. I don't believe it does there, so I think we're okay. What I might do is just swing it around just a little. Doesn't quite seem to be lined up right there. So we can swing it around. Whoops, not nowhere near that much. Just a little that way. Yes, there we go. And then shuffle it over just a tad. So it's real in the centre of the area. There we go. Okay, good. So now we'll go back into here and we'll edit it. And we'll get rid of all this, because we just want one, first of all, because we're going to make a bit more of a grid, Don't normally do scenery on camera during the Let's Play series, but I kind of want to go through a little bit of this with you. So we'll go to the wall decorations and we'll get the longer plank. And I'm hoping, yep, that's pretty much where I want it actually, but then I want it over here. And we're going to do it long ways. In fact, pretty much exactly there. A little bit of a gap. So we've actually got a slatted... There we go. And we'll do that again. There we go. Just grabbing them each time and adding them to the piece that I'm duplicating. I think I just need three there. And that's near enough. Near enough spot on. Yeah, very happy with that. And then I want to take some of the ivy, which won't be in any of this scenery. There we go. Take some of this sort of over the top ivy and place it over the top. But I'm actually going to do that once the thing's been moved. That's pressed the wrong button. Excuse me. Let's just add that again. Once the bit's been moved, there we go. So, okay, so we'll select all of these. Come on. There we go. And the big boy as well. And then we'll duplicate. And then we'll just... I was going to grab them all again, but we might as well just keep doing it this way for now. Probably just as quick. There we go. And it's going to provide a nice little bit of shade for the people who are queuing there. And also, it looks a little bit more interesting. And then we can take some of this stuff and kind of add it. I think we're getting some slight issues with the game lately. I don't know if you noticed during that Let's Build, but a few times trying to add pieces down, and it really isn't wanting to. I don't quite know why. But, you know, something to definitely keep an eye on. We'll have a little bit coming off this one. And it'll spring that way. It might probably... again, sort of play around with this off camera until I'm really happy with it, but you know, yeah, it's that sort of thing. Some ivy on the top. We'll probably have some of the dangly stuff as well, like we've done over here as well. But yeah, that's kind of what I was going for. We'll have a little bit of work with that later on, maybe. Okay, so let's have a look. Let's go up to 100%. I think this is a $10 at the minute. I mean, we could double that. We don't need to. We have over $250,000 or Planconian dollars, whatever it is. But I'm pretty sure $20, people still pay that. Let's have a look. Is anyone walking away? People may be walking away now at $20. No, still happy to pay it. You weren't happy to pay it. What did you think? Park entry is free. You have no issue. You're walking away as well. It may just be that they're... I don't have enough money to go on it. Well, if that's the case, you need to go home. $26. You've got $26. Oh, it's group cash. Yeah, okay. So what are people thinking now? People are still queuing. Yeah, I'm happy with that. Okay, the gold rush, there we go. Like I say, I'll do a little bit more work on that. I'll pop that into the Steam Workshop as well. Right, so that's not all we wanted to do this episode. I did want to start considering this last coaster, although I've got a feeling it may well be a two-episode job. I'm going to try and get the base layout done and then see what tweaks we need to make to it. So let's have a look. We've got stuff researched. Oh, we have. What have we got here? You are a Cloud Runner coaster, okay. The Freedom of Flight, that's going to be that weird... Well, we definitely aren't using that thing to make a 100-meter high drop. Phenomenal speed and track overlap. Not too sure what either of those are. But we can get $3,000 each on those. But I'm pretty sure we're going to be going with... the Giga Coaster that we've got unlocked, or is it a Hyper Coaster? Let's have a look. We have the Equalizer Hyper Coaster, or the Anubis Hyper Coaster. I don't believe we have a Giga unlocked, so it's going to be one of those, because it has to have a huge, massive drop. Huge, massive drop. A biggish drop of at least 100 meters. So let's have a go. That was a weird noise, wasn't it? Let's have a go with the Equalizer or the Anubis. Which one do we like the look of? That's a funky one, but I think I'm going to go with this one. Okay, So this needs to have at least 8 excitements, at most 5 fear, an average pace of 35 miles an hour, and a huge drop. So this has basically got to be a giga coaster, a big old giga coaster. So we're going to cheat a little, make it super high at the beginning. We're going to go straight into the lift hill, and we'll go down to about, no, let's do 10 meters just to be, well, no, it really doesn't matter, does it, actually? But you're going to come up 45 degrees. You're going to come straight up. We're going to go straight into here until we get to about 113. Where's the thing? We're going to have a big super drop down here, and then we're going to go off that way. That's going to be the plan. Nice big turning drop. 113. The problem is we're hitting some... We might have to do a bit of terrain work here. Let's... excuse me. Sorry, I felt that one coming. Right, we'll bring you down there. Get you off. Okay, here we go. So we're going to bring you right down. Oh, no, as long as you... Oh, no, maybe not that long. How can we... No, there we go. Because we want you pretty much... My biggest concern here now is that the fear on this thing is going to be mega. But we'll give it a go. We're going to start there. We're going to turn it a little. Oops, that... No, which way? That way. Yeah. Excuse me, I'm going to cough again. I'm going to take a cut and just get a glass of water. Oh, sorry about that. Right, excuse me. Right, let's have a look. I'm dying here. That's the kind of thing I want to do. Maybe not that extreme. Let's just very sort of slowly end up going this way. Let's have a little zoom. See how we're getting on. Yeah, that's going to be there. And then it's going to really start to come in at the end there as we begin to come up. I mean, that may well be a bit too extreme. You're going to have to start leveling out here before we hit the ground. So I would say that's your lowest point. That's 20 meters. And this up here is 131. So that should be... That should be the drop. And I mean, you know, these things look pretty good. You know, they don't look like they've had to go too high. But I mean, it just looks ridiculous, doesn't it, that height? But I mean, look at it compared to this arrow here. Whoa. But you know, I think that's it. So we're going to start the test. We're going to have to drag this chain speed up a lot, because that's going to affect the average speed, I think. I think that still affects average speed. But off it goes. It's going up. Pretty extreme. I want to see the sort of fear levels when we get to here, because that's going to be our danger point for getting up to this at most 5 fear. I mean, obviously, it's an average of 5 fear, but if this gets up to like 10, 11 fear here, we've got no chance of keeping it down anywhere else. So let's have a look. Height, we can't do anything about now. Excitement, we don't need to worry about just yet either. Excitement is really high. Fear is peaking at 5, 6, 7, 8. So, you know, fear is getting pretty intense there. But hopefully it'll average out. Let's see. We want to start going back up here. And we need to go really high here, because this is not an airtime jobby. This is a straight up, you know, want to get the height out. We probably could do with this being a bit smoother, but hopefully the smoothing tool will be all we need. Also, what I want to do is turn off auto tunnel, because that'll start banking it out for us nicely. Ah, I've just thought, we still have a bit of a turn on this, don't we? Oh dear, we can fix that though, it's not a problem. From here, pretty much it needs to be, from there it needs to be teetering off, here it needs to be smoothed out. Totally forgot, do that all the time in these games. Put that back to zero. Uh-oh. I'm going to struggle doing it now, aren't I? Let's get in here so we can see it. It's not giving me any form of rotation. I still think that's a bit much. there, I think it is. Let's have a look. Oh no, that's going the other way now. Is that still doing it? Yeah, okay. In that case, let's start again. From here, we now don't have one on it, do we? There we go. We want zero, and we want that to be straight. And I want you to begin to go up. There we go. Okay, let's try that again. So we're going to take it up to... Let's even go a little higher. It's got a real nice big old curve on that. 60 degrees seems to be where it peaks, but that's fine. And we'll take you up to there. And then we'll start to begin to average out there. Fear definitely sort of caps out on that first drop. So we're okay now. That's got a quite a nice curve around there. It doesn't have to be any length, does it? But the biggest drop of 100 metres is the main thing. Like I say, I only worry that the fear here might just be too difficult to... let's just smooth a little and smooth the bank in as well. It might be a little bit too much for it, but we'll see. So let's... most five fear, 8 excitement, average speed of 35 miles an hour. There really isn't much we can do about that. You know, it's going to hit it or it isn't. Let's take you up. Take you this way a bit. We'll do a nice big curve here. So what sort of height are we at? 103. Let's take it that way. Actually, we'll take you there. We'll have to figure that out a little bit with smoothing, but we need you to really kind of get up here, to be honest. In fact, we need to probably go higher there. Oh no, there's still a curve on you there that I don't want. There we go. Because this is a huge coaster, this thing. 103, so we'll start to peter you out, maybe a little less than that. We'll start to get rid of you about 85, that's good. Okay. Alright, that seems pretty good. Okay, it's getting over that first hill nicely. I mean, super high. Fear is just too high on this. That's my main worry at the minute. I've got a feeling the fear is just capping out too high. We'll make a big loop. I know these rides don't normally loop, but we might as well go around King Coaster rather than attempt to tightly turn back on ourselves here. So let's just try basically sticking in hills and seeing what happens. We'll probably have to leave it there and then come back to fix it in the next one. Basically just taking off about sort of 10 or so meters off each one. Maybe a little more than that, actually. 73, that one is. Okay, and then we'll start to come around again here. We'll just have a little... Actually, we'll have a little bit of a straight run first before we start doing anything. There we go. Come this way. Up a little. To about there is perfect. There we go, and then we'll straighten you up again. So 73, so this time we want to think about going about... Yeah, 58, that seems pretty good. Up it down, and drop. Okay, and then... Let's... what can we do? I mean, the stuff, but I mean... Oh, we could look at doing something like that, actually. Although you're not really going the right way for us. And you're probably a little big. What else have we got? Helix up. The helixes are a bit too tight, really, the automatic ones. I mean, I kind of want to see if it actually makes it something like that. Where is it on the test? Can't even see where it is. Is it even testing right now? Oh, does it just see it go past? No, that was just a bit of a graphic glitch. Oh, here it is. Yeah, let's build it, just see what happens. Yeah, it gets over there pretty nicely. Like I say, the fear is just staying a bit too high for me. I'm hoping that the off points just sort of take the edge out of it. But he's constantly sort of sitting somewhere, sort of like 6, 7, 8 it was then. Crazy bit there. Hopefully a bit of smoothing will sort that out. Let's see what it does here. Sphere constantly sitting 8, 9. Just a bit too much, I think. Although, it does get around there quite nicely. Kind of want to leave that in. And then I'm going to struggle to get back to where we need to be. Suppose we could try coming up and over here. To this sort of area, yeah. And then bringing it down. There we go. Oops. Yeah, sometimes, I don't know if it's the mouse or the game, but quite often lately, it's just not been registering clicks. Okay, I'm going to go back to here, stick a few brakes on it. We'll have a block brake. And let's just try autocomplete. Okay, that is probably will lose a lot of speed here, but I'm just curious now. Let's click done and go into this testing mode. And let's actually Gold Rush, great value at £20. While that's going, I did say we would ride this once it was decorated. I know we haven't done that much decoration, but oh, look at that for timing. We'll speed up till we get going. Ooh, there we go. In fact, we'll speed up through this as well. Okay, we'll give this a ride. Whee! Yeah, so I do think this could probably do with a little bit more work and would make quite a nice addition to my Steam Workshop. I haven't got any rides on there at the moment. It's just been scenery pieces, so I think that'll work out pretty good. Love the sound of the woodies. They sound amazing. And I know that we have the optional catwalk on pretty much all the way around, but for me, it makes it look so much better. Put your hands down. Love that where we cut underneath it as well. That's great. Yeah, block brake section acts really naturally. Takes a bit of the speed out of the ride as we start to come back to the finish. Nice sort of helix down. Nice couple of head chopper moments. And you see that thing in the distance there. Looks like we're about to go up it. But just at the last minute, we have a little double down. And we come back into the station. Maybe a bit too much speed, but overall, pretty happy with that. Okay, cool. Right, let's see how this thing's doing. What have we got here? Testing. Yeah, fear is just through the roof. The excitement's fine, but this fear is just through the roof. And it seems to be, the problem is, at the base of these drops. Let's have a look for the highest drop. Biggest drop is 107 meters, so that's not bad. Okay, so that's okay. Average speed, more than enough. Basically, we're too quick. So what I think we need to do is leave this drop as it is and deal with the fact that it's got a lot of fear on the first drop, but then we can actually just sort of go around and basically just smooth out from here to here like that. Smooth all. It'll take a little bit of the height out of the drop. In fact, we could even go probably more like that. Smooth all, and you'll see that bottom of the drop hopefully come up a little bit. It really doesn't seem to be doing as much as I want it to. Basically want that to be about there, really. So let's try that and then smooth it. See if that makes a difference. So the fear was up in the sevens somewhere. So we're going to hope this makes a difference. I've got a feeling the G-force here is going to be too extreme. Because look at it. Yeah, there. Well, that's going to feel like it's absolutely throwing you out the ride. So that'll obviously make the fear high. So we'll smooth that a little. And we'll do the same on the other side. There we go. And then we'll take this area here to here and here to here. And we'll basically bank the hell out of that. I mean, it's really, so you're feeling more like you're being pushed down into your seat as opposed to anything else. So we'll smooth the bank in there. And then we'll smooth the banking here. Okay, good. So let's have a look at the heat maps for fear there. Okay, so Fia was sort of 7.3. Yeah, that airpoint 3 there. So let's let it go around again and have a look at those updated values. Let's get the speed up on the thing. It's coming up here. So, yeah, it's, I mean, obviously that's really low there. It's a bit of a key point there. It only gets up to 8.3 there. See, that's already great. That's already knocked it down to 6.3, 6.5. So, basically, we need to kind of go through and get rid of all those peaks. There's a huge bit of peaking over here. What's that there? Again, it looks like it's going to be a banking issue. Okay, right. In the next episode, then, we will basically finish off this coaster. Multiple research products are ready to be revealed. Let's have a look at those. Research. We've got a... I don't know what that one is. No idea. Looks good, though. And an invincible... Ah, that was kind of the one I was waiting for, to be honest. Last one to do is the steepest drops, but we'll get it going just in case. All right, cool. Yeah, so we'll finish off that. We'll sort the fear out on it. We'll do a little bit of work with it, and we'll talk about the scenarios and where we're up to with them. We still do have two scenarios to do, the ones that came with the two of the ones that came with the winter update. So we'll probably will look at doing those if you guys are interested. Thank you very much for watching. Hope you've enjoyed it. If you have, please give us a like. It really does help at the channel. And if you're not already, don't forget to subscribe. Apologies for there not being a Let's Build this week. I'm afraid I had to pick up some overtime in work, and I just haven't had a day to sit down and play. At the moment, I'm having to do Let's Plays of games because I can just sort of sit down for 20 minutes, 30 minutes and record a video, as opposed to the Let's Plays, Let's Builds even, that take, a good part of 5 or 6 hours to make a 10-minute video. thank you very much for watching, though. If any thoughts, queries, or suggestions, pop them down in the comments. And if you fancy a chat, you can find me on Twitter. I'm @JontySparrow. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.